Hey everybody, and welcome to episode 22 of Let's Build Minecraft. If you look around, you can see that I've done quite a bit of work off camera here. We're just building a wall here, and then we'll get to the more exciting stuff and show you what I've actually done. For those of you who are curious how I'm doing my walls, and I talked about this last episode, but it's really just randomizing between these three blocks, and then, you know, there's absolutely no pattern to it. Let's put that there. Oh no, not over the carrots, because, yeah, we have carrots. And why do we have carrots? Because we need them for pigs. All right, let's take a step back. I think we put one there. There. Now let's take out the half slabs. Maybe like... Wait. Let's get a wall. Get out of here. Yeah, that's good depth. And then we go on top and sprinkle it. Just a pinch of walls and slabs. So yeah, let's just take a step back and look at what we've got. Right here is today's project. We got pigs. I really wanted to bring some life into our village. It's a farming village. We've got wheat down. we've got wheat down. And I've even added more wheat and plan on adding more wheat. I wouldn't mind this whole hill that you see here being wheat. I have my render distance pretty low, I think. Ah, it's fine. It's fine for having these shaders on. I wish I could have fog rolling in with low render distance, but on shaders, I don't think that that's a possibility. I think it cuts out the fog, even if you set it to it. But anyway, this is what we're going to be doing today. I've just kind of laid out a floor plan, and I just threw those together. So for those of you who don't know how to like make a floor plan, or if you're making a town with that's an eyesore. If you're making a town with lots of different buildings and you don't know how to add variation, just add squares. Add squares and work with it. Yeah. Right here I added quite a bit of life. Just add some leaves, fence. Not only is there that upper section of carrots right there, which I have plans. I think I'm going to put, like, have the field going, like, back to here, and then maybe a little carrot farmer house back here, you know, something like that. This is kind of the edge of the city right here. The city is going to keep going on that way, but, you know, we're getting deeper into it. I'm still collecting carrots, and I've been playing in default texture pack. And it's kind of hard to see the carrots in this texture pack, but I've been grabbing them when I see them pop up and then planting more. But I've got that upper level and this lower level, and that really adds some depth. That's really the theme that we're going for here, is different levels of fields separated by these walls. And that's another thing that I've done. I have finished these walls down here. Let's see if we can get down without trampling. Looks like I've already trampled there. I added this entire wall right here from about there to here. It's a nice feeling standing around in here. That cow, I enjoy the wildlife. The piggies, the horses, the cow. Oh, that reminds me. We have a new friend. I'll bring you over here to meet him. This is Kevin. Kevin is our wheelbarrow chicken. And if you don't know how to, or if you want to know how to make this wheelbarrow, it's a half slab with a bolt on top of it, these for wheels, and then gate on the back. So that's our, it used to work better when you didn't have the paddles, but anyway, that's our wheelbarrow. And Kevin wandered in there and got stuck, and we named him, and he's laying eggs, but I'm afraid to grab it. Oh, I grabbed it, because if you hit it, it does knock the boat out of place. Be free. Oh, I don't really have a huge plan for this. for this house that we're going to make. So whatever we end up in the end is just as much of a surprise to me as it is to you. Let's see. I grabbed this crafting table, even though we have one right there, I just realized. Let's just tuck it away right there. So the big plan that I have right now is sticking with the theme of these houses of having a lower entrance and an upper entrance. You can see it right here. Our lower entrance is going to be right here, and unlike those houses, it's going to stick out from the rest of the house. Our upper entrance is going to be right here. This right here is actually going to be a shelter area for the pigs, so this is going to be open to the outside. Hi! And I really haven't been breeding these guys, but there's a extension. I don't know if it's a whole new plains biome or an extension to biomes down there. But there were like 10 pigs over there. I grabbed them, like all of them, and brought them over here. And then right here, there's going to be like a little shack leading to the to here that a farmer could get into. And let's kind of mark that just to give us an idea of what we're planning on doing. We're going to have a pet cow in it, so it's going to be really cool. How to start? Okay, for those of you wondering how to start a building like this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build what I know is going to be here. I know, actually, let's keep that there. I know that there's going to be a staircase right here. What I don't know, actually, I'm going to go with it, and you'll see what I'm talking about. But anyways, three high, yeah. So how are you guys? If you watched my last episode, you know that I just got back from to some cobble. I think that's what I've been using, but it doesn't hurt to mix it up if it's not. I just got back from a wedding, a friend's wedding. I don't think I told you my little adventure that I had. We're gonna need more bricks. So I mentioned, I believe, that my plane was canceled the night that we were supposed to leave. It started raining. There was like a flood warning and everything. It was pretty bad. Which is, you know, my luck. And so it was a nighttime flight, which was already kind of crappy. Like, I didn't really want to be there for a nighttime flight. But, you know, it's whatever. I wouldn't really want a morning flight either. But anyways, we had to drive about 40 miles. That may be wrong, but I can't remember. I'm just trying to make a little, you know, let's make it something that we can actually get into. We'll dress this up later if we need to. Maybe put some hay under there like we have been. And then get some more oak. So yeah, the flight was canceled, and it was not like in the town that we were staying at. So my wife's mom drove us to this town at like 8 at night or whatever. And then it got canceled. We sat there for 3 hours before it got canceled. And this is a pretty I was gonna say a small town. It's a small city. It's not like a major city. We're gonna need more fence. So it's like 11 o'clock. We're in a town where we don't really have any friends there, so we can't, you know, crash at anyone's place. We did have friends from the town, but they were not in town, so they weren't any use. So we called a taxi. And this is a Monday night, mind you. And we said, all right, well, let's go to a cab, or let's have the cab take us to a hotel. I think he took us to about 7 hotels, and every single one of them was full. I was just looking at, just making sure I wasn't missing any walls, but let's do this one really quick. We took went to like 7 hotels, and they were all full. And this guy was helping us. Like, he called one of his friends, Let's get some. We already have Kabul right there. He was calling all of his friends at like random motel or something, and he's like, "Do you have any rooms?" And the guy's like, "No." And he's like, "Well, I'm watching out for these people. I really need rooms." He's like, "Do you have any out of service rooms?" And he was like, "My out of service rooms even have people in them, so we couldn't stay in those." So he tried, but we were not able to get a room. So eventually, there were a few hotels that I was like, "I'm not taking you to these. They're not hotels that you want to go to." Sorry, I'm taking a little break from building here so I can think. And actually, let's just throw in a little window. It's little things like this, I think, add. Oh no, that add a little bit of flavor to a house. Now there's going to be a roof there, but anyways, I think we will add this roof now. This can go here. So we end up going to like this like budget inn or something, and he's like, "Well, they just redid like the front half of the motel, but if they try to give you a back room, don't take it." And they gave us the room furthest in the back, and so we ended up saying no to that. Let's get some stairs here. So we turned down that, ended up calling up her mom, who, because my wife, she really didn't want to stay there. She called up her mom, and she came and got us. Now, here's another little trick that I like to do. I like to raise the roof lines above the windows, and we're going to do that on both sides, I think. Yeah. So it takes her another 45 minutes to come get us. At this point, we get home. It's about 2. We had been rebooked for a flight at... can I get back up there? I cannot. Let's get some dirt. We had been rebooked for a flight at 6 a.m. So we got about 3 hours of sleep. And we set 3 alarms. I don't remember any of them. My wife doesn't remember any of them. The alarms were all close to her, so I guess she shut them off in her sleep or something. But we woke up like 45 minutes late, and yeah, it was less than ideal. We did make it to the flight, though, and all the flights that day were smooth sailing. Good morning, Kevin. Now, something that we had been forgetting about on this roof over here, on those little trimming things, do I have? Yeah, we put walls up there. We forgot about that on these. I think I'll climb up there and do that. Last episode, I forgot. I finally remembered that I forgot to do those random hay bale styles, but on this one, I forgot to stagger the stairs and the... and the full blocks. I also mixed in to this one stone and brick. You know, it's nothing real noticeable. It adds texture, though. So I'm going to keep it. I might even do it along the bottom of these or something. Or maybe some of these are newer and they aren't broken apart or something. I'm not sure. Inconsistency might not be a bad thing. This looks like an older building, and maybe that's fine. Maybe this farm was here a long time ago, and then people started building around them. But anyways, our next part is going to be this, and let me just think about it for a little. Something that those of you that watch me always hear me talk about, and that is depth. Now, we're going to push back this part right here coming up from these stairs. Let's get some railing right there. And we want this to be uniform. This messes this up. I'll fix this real quick. All right, sweet. So yeah, this upper part in, and you're gonna really notice it when you're back here, and you notice that there's an indented section compared to this wall. And when you're in here, you're still gonna have this section right here. Now, we might have to do something to cover up this cobblestone. Maybe it'll be fine the way it is. We're really gonna have to see how it looks once we've done it. Now, the next thing is we've been putting pillars. Let's see, I'm trying to figure what we want to do with these corners right here. We have been putting pillars to add depth. We definitely don't need to right here because that'll block the stairway. Back here, I also don't think we do need to because the stairway itself is adding depth. So I think right there we are fine, as opposed to here we added these pillars onto the corners. And I also did it on these. So we added something so that we could take something away, kind of. Does that make sense? Another thing that I just realized is pigs are dirty. Pigs are nasty, right? They live in the mud. They're slimy, greasy pigs, right? So I think that I'm gonna remove all this, put down, I'm thinking like, I'm not soul sand. That's a dirty looking thing, but I don't really want it. It'd be too much of a pain in the butt. Maybe for the sake of how it looks, we will throw soul sand in. We'll definitely add path blocks. Those kind of look like mud. I'm gonna have to get back to you on that. Look at the blocks. Coarse dirt. What else have we been using? Gravel, maybe? No, gravel doesn't really look like mud. It looks like gravel. But either way, we're going to want to do it before we get many more pigs. So I might also do that while I make some more progress on this house. I added doors. Good night, Kevin. All right, I thought of some things and I've tested some things. I got thinking, what looks like mud? That, right? That looks like mud. Now, I'm not going to till the whole thing, but what I wanted to test was, when you kill animals, do they trample it? And I just killed two cows on top of some tilled earth, and it did not trample it. Now, these pigs shouldn't be jumping for anything, I don't think. So I don't think that that's going to trample anything. If it doesn't, I guess we're just gonna learn the hard way. But the thing that we're gonna have to do is figure out a way to hide some water. I'm gonna probably hide under some leaves, but until then, let's just make it easy for ourselves and put some there. And I'm gonna grab some more, put some here, I guess. And then maybe here, and maybe we can skip out on putting so much tilled earth there or something. Okay, I've got a little test area here. Maybe I shouldn't have done it here, because now I gotta replace all this stuff. I wanted to test out wood. Now, it's dark, and this wood in particular is kind of grimy. Does that look like mud? I think it could, but I'm not sure that I'm sold on it. Let's try this. Now, I think that can work. I don't know about this. Yeah, I don't know about that. I think I'm gonna try with the dark oak wood. Maybe you could even throw in some spruce wood to add some variety, and we may do that. I'm not entirely sure what we're doing quite yet. Yeah. I'm gonna be the first to say that this looks nasty. Like, the textures, the colors, is just, it looks pretty nasty in here. Which I think is pretty fitting for these pigs. It's maybe not the best out there. I don't know, maybe some of you guys don't like the wood. To me, it looks like mud in this, in the way that is being used. But what really bothers me is just like straight edge grass right here. And you can't put a path block here. You can't till it. So maybe we put, maybe we mix in some coarse dirt like this and maybe some logs. Oh no, that's gonna dry up. No, no, oh crap. I gotta fix that quick. Got it before anything dried up, I think. There's some dirt in here, but it's coarse dirt. And you, I have that trap door there. Yeah, there's water under that, which isn't ideal. When we get more pigs in here, I don't want to like fill it to the brim with pigs. I'm probably not gonna be eating pig. So this is mostly aesthetic. Maybe like twice as many pigs as there are now would maybe even be pushing it. But you know, we'll try to get it looking like a well-stocked pig pen. And we also need to remember that this is part of the pig pen. But what's gonna be the next part we work on? So that part's done, except for our hay roof. So let's figure out this part. One last thing, I did want to throw in some plants here and there to make it look like weeds are growing through. Where else? Right there, right there. Yeah. Heck yeah, two of them right next to each other. Yeah, now it's looking good. Now I like it. My solution to this... Uh-oh, too far. Yeah, you. I need you. My solution to this strip of cobblestone that we had right there is this. We're gonna have just the roof, the second story floor be cobble, and then we're gonna actually have this floor drop down a block. And let's light this up. So that nothing bothers us. And then fill these in. The outside of the house is about 90% done. We got all these carrots. I could probably fill up a good bit of this flat. Hello? Okay. My screen just froze there. I don't know if it froze for you. But anyway, yeah, this is what I got. It's not done, and we're not gonna finish it this episode for a few reasons. I'm like running out of resources. I have one hay bale left. That's why we didn't do the funky random hay rooftop, and that's gonna take, you know, quite a bit of hay collecting. Unfortunately, that does take a while, so I'm not gonna have time for that before this goes up. But let's just get a walk around. I really like how this front entrance part turned out. I like this for the most part. Something's gotta break up. Let's let some light through there. This is what I'm really unhappy with. I said that was okay to have that flush, just boring without a pillar. It doesn't look quite right to me, but then again, these aren't houses that are supposed to stand out. I mean, these are like townhouses. So, little things like that are maybe okay. And I'm just being a little too hard on myself. I ran out of oak wood as well, so I didn't put a pillar there. But that may be something that we need to do. This right here, I don't really know what to do with. There's like a little lip here. And it's really weird. But this upstairs room is really small. But you can't really tell from looking at it from the outside. From the outside, it looks fine. So, as far as fitting into the town, I think it's good. I mean, really, all I did was... When I placed on that layout, it was, like, really just random. I was going to try to show you. I only have one cobblestone, but it's a bad idea anyway. It probably was going to be a bad demonstration. I really just randomized the shape of the layout, and then I went up with it with the walls, and then decided where I wanted a stairwell to be, and, you know, that kind of helped pull everything together. Back here, we're not done with this either. The inside of this needs to be touched up on. But all in all, we have a new building in our town. We have a new field in our town, so a lot of new walls. So I like where it's gone. We're going to end up having to bring a road maybe through here, right where I'm walking, to here. Not really sure what's going to go here. I was planning on this being the first house in the town. Maybe we have some kind of tower here to just watch over the harbor. That seems like something that would be at the entrance of a town, right? Maybe we have an actual, like, gate to the town. I don't know. Something's got to go here. It could just be a garden or somewhat empty space to add to the atmosphere. But if you have ideas on that kind of stuff, or if you have any ideas on what houses you'd like to see. Oh, man, I love this. I love when you get to the point where you can go down a road and you can take a turn and there's more houses. Next, I want to be able to take another turn and see more houses. So right here, going to add houses here soon. This is going up. Still have to finish this off. And once we do, you know, there will be a section to build right here for port stuff. Because this is for the port. This is for, like, an elevator for bringing hay down to the docks from up here. So we'll have some, like, section up here. Some big walkway or something. This is where I was messing around with those cows. If you're wondering why there's, like, field rings. Is that what they call them? Like, the aliens when they leave? Yeah, signs. How come it's so hard to trample a crop when you want to, but you don't want to, you fall on it, and it's, there's like no chance that it doesn't. Well, that's a, yeah, something can get stuck in there, but now, not anymore. I'll have to fill that up with dirt sometime. But anyways, oh, look at that. That looks cool in the distance. But yeah, I like what we're doing. I like these pigs. In fact, let's finish off by feeding these pigs a little. All these carrots should be grown by now. Let's just grab a bunch of them. I'll plant them back later. Yeah, actually, let's just do it right now. Just do it really quick. Run out of time. I have no idea how long this video is. Last one was really short, but I think that's okay. I think it's okay to have short videos. It is. Let's find a way to jump in right there. Hey, piggy, piggy, piggies. Come here. Come into here. This is the feeding area. Oh, we could add a trough in here. That would be cool. Just get fed. Fat piggies. Give me that experience. I want to get to level 30 over and over and over and over, and that's what I've been trying to do. I did get to level 30 and enchanted another book, and I got protection 3, which... Oh, look at all the little baby piggies. Aww. Let's draw them all out here and take a screenshot. There we go. I'm just in creative to get the screenshot, so chill. Just don't even, right there. Let's try a few more. When I put them in, the size for the screen, for the thumbnails is smaller than my screen, so it's ideal if we have them out like this a little bit so I don't have to do any resizing. But I took a few there. Get back into survival mode, where we belong. I like how this pig pen turned out. I really think that adds a lot. Just like a completely different section compared to all of this. It's like really nice, beautiful golden fields. And bleh, pigs. They're not even that dirty. These are clean piggies in this texture pack. But anyway, that is going to be it for today. Get some of that done off camera, perhaps. Get some more of this field work done. But this is where I'm going to leave you guys. So thank you for watching. If you enjoy it, then leave a like and subscribe. Bye. What I do, da da do, da da do.